These two foods, or more accurately stated, ingestible substances that really do melt visceral fat, the most harmful fat on your body. In fact, this study that I'll show you might begin to change my mind about something fundamental that I believed, or still believe. This is the study that researchers split people randomly into three nutrition groups. One group consumed a healthy diet guidelines diet, which is just a general balanced diet recommending whole foods, limiting saturated fat and sugar, and focusing on vegetables, fruits, and whole grains. The second diet was a Mediterranean diet focused on reducing simple carbohydrates, increased unsaturated fats. And the third diet was the Mediterranean diet, but including two additions, green tea and Wolfia globosa, also called duckweed. Duckweed is a high-fiber, high-protein plant most common to Asia. This nutrition condition was dubbed the Green Med condition. Now, there were some additional key differences between the nutrition groups. One, only the Mediterranean diets were on a supposed calorie deficit, not the healthy dietary guidelines control diet. In addition, the Mediterranean diet, including the green tea and the duckweed, so the Green Med, replaced their protein with plant protein from this duckweed. Of note, there were no significant differences across the groups, save for women in the Green Med group had slightly lower visceral body fat than in the other two groups, but the men were the same in that regard. The study was well-powered with almost 300 participants. The study ran for a year and a half, and all groups were also encouraged to participate in the same exercise program. So, what happened? As usual, let's crack open the data. We can see the results. The green is the Green Med diet, the blue is the normal Mediterranean diet, and the red is the healthy diet guidelines control diet. The VAT change there is the visceral fat, the type of body fat that infiltrates and surrounds our organs and is heavily connected to disease. So the less, the better. Here, the researchers are measuring the amount of visceral fat reduction from baseline to 18 months later. The asterisks under each bar indicate a statistically significant difference in a within diet comparison. So, just indicating improvement over time for each diet individually. However, the p-values above indicate a between diet comparison. The cutoff for statistical significance was 0.05. So anything under that indicates a likely effect. So interestingly, all diets led to an improvement in visceral fat, which is wonderful to see, especially since only two of the groups were encouraged to be in a calorie deficit. However, by eye and by statistic, the Green Med diet outperformed both other diets, indicating a mere addition of these two substances led to significantly more visceral fat loss. In fact, around three times more. I'll show you images in a minute. First, what are these other results? Here we're looking at subcutaneous fat, or fat that sits right under the skin layer. This type of fat is less dangerous than visceral fat, and interestingly, again, all three diets reduce it. And there is a trend in the data, again, favoring the Green Med condition, although it's only the deeper regions of the subcutaneous fat. This might again indicate that these compounds specifically target a type of fat that is more dangerous, which is just wildly cool. Let's get to the images of the visceral fat in MRI scans, and also which factors in the diet were most strongly linked to this improvement in visceral fat. Also, there's more to say on the exercise routine, the green tea and the duckweed, a few other details like the 10-year risk of cardiovascular disease that don't fit into this video. So I'm adding it to the extended version of this video, which is available for the Physionic Insiders, my premium research review, including podcasts, a premium community, access to all my analyses, shortened summaries, a premium email list, and more. It's a steal, if I may, well, biasly say. It's linked in the description box. Hope to see you there. Here are the images of the visceral fat, and there's something here that really opened up my eyes to something that I never believed before. Those are MRI scans across all three diet conditions, from baseline on top to 18 months later, bottom. The green is the visceral fat, and the quantified values are at the bottom. Again, we confirmed that VAT loss, that's visceral fat, was greatest in the green med condition. However, one aspect that I was skeptical about was the fact that the researchers failed to measure calorie intake. Yes, I mentioned before that calorie intake was reduced for both Mediterranean diets, yet it wasn't actually measured. In fact, they were given a range of calories to aim for, which leaves more room for error. So my question was, is the visceral fat loss from the green tea and the duckweed, or was it from the greater weight loss due to the greater calorie deficit? The answer is, at least in part, here. My initial belief was that a calorie deficit was the major, if not only, way to target a subset of fat. However, if you look at the amount of weight loss between the Mediterranean diets, it's the same. Yet the visceral fat loss is double in the green condition. This suggests that the effects are independent of caloric intake, as caloric intake was likely similar, and the effects are likely driven by the two consumables. One more word of caution. This still isn't foolproof because we're looking at representative people's images, not the average result across 300 participants. But assuming that this holds true, this opens my mind to the idea that calories are not the only primary driver of visceral fat loss. Okay, but speaking to that, the researchers quantified some associations with different factors that could contribute to this outsized visceral fat loss. For example, looking at total polyphenol count in the blood of participants, we see the amount of visceral fat loss on the horizontal axis, and we see three different levels of blood polyphenols in ascending order. So the greater one's polyphenol levels are, the greater the association to visceral fat loss relative to low polyphenol levels. Polyphenols are naturally occurring molecules found in plants that are believed to play a role in protecting the body through antioxidant abilities, anti-inflammatory abilities, and more. Let's look at some other associations, like here. Here we see that less red meat consumption up top is linked to greater reductions in visceral fat than less red meat. Or if we look at one of the main ingredients, mungkai consumption, which is the duckweed, i.e. Wolfia globosa, there's an association with reduced visceral fat with greater mungkai consumption. Makai consumption. It's one of those. These associations are adjusted for sex and age, so they aren't adjusted enough to make definitive claims, as there's plenty of room for other variables to explain these results. So, where does that leave us? What to do? Well, here are the takeaways. One, we know a healthier diet focused on whole foods plus exercise improves visceral fat modestly. Two, a more potent diet that triples visceral fat loss is a calorie-restricted Mediterranean diet, including daily green tea and Wolfia globosa, i.e. duckweed, consumption. That said, if you're interested in understanding how visceral fat contributes to disease, you should check out this video on the personal fat threshold and another way of reversing visceral fat.